Evaluation of utilization of both GPUs and CPUs. Using the pinned memory and the Warp2 kernel with texture memory, simulations are performed for CPQDs with a convergence criterion of 10⁻⁷ electron volts and are completed when 104 Lanczos iterations are reached or 10 lowest energy levels in conduction band are found. Every bar graph of has the following 6 elements: MPI communication, COM, data transfer from host to GPU device, copy in, SBMV plus data transfer from GPU device to host, SBMV plus copy out, dot product, VV dot, memory operations, memop, and other portions, others. Note that SBMV plus copy out includes the time required for SBMV on GPU devices and data transfer from GPU device to host memory, while SBMV on CPUs is performed at the same time. Performance of queue and code with GPUs computing using the pinned memory and the Warp2 kernel with texture memory. A. Strong scalability of computing 30x80x80 unit cells at the K40 testbed. B. Weak scalability of computing 15x80x80 unit cells per single MPI process at the K40 testbed. C. Performance of computing 30x80x80 unit cells as a function of the GPU load at the K40 testbed. D. Performance comparison of computing 30x80x80 unit cells as a function of the GPU load at the P100 testbed. A. and B. presents the strong and weak scalability of the end-to-end simulation at the K40 and P100 testbeds, respectively. The CPQD tested for the strong scalability has a cuboid C layer that consists of a total of 30x80x80 unit cells and has a dimension of (16 nanometers × 43 nanometers × 43 nanometers), about 1.5 million atoms. The problem size for the weak scalability test is 15 n × 80x80 unit cells, n × 7.5 × 105 atoms, where n denotes the number of MPI ranks. As we use 10 bases to describe a single atom, the degrees of freedom, DOF, of corresponding Hamiltonian matrices are 15 million, for strong scalability, and 7.5 million/rank, for weak scalability, respectively. Here, we see that the strong scalability is generally quite good, where each MPI rank is mapped to 10 CPU cores and 1 GPU card. The job using 6 MPI ranks is 2.34 times faster than the one executed with 2 ranks for the 30x80x80 unit cells at the K40 testbed. It shows nice scales according to the number of cores, because a significant portion of the wall time is taken by SBMV that would give a nice scalability as the matrix has a block tridiagonal shape, and therefore the burden of MPI communications would not become a serious problem. The weak scalability also shows good since the wall time is not significantly affected by MPI communications. In addition, C, and, D, illustrates the performance comparison in terms of the wall time according to the GPU load at the K40 and P100 testbeds, respectively. The QD considered for the experiment here has 30x80x80 unit cells. The elapsed time is described as a function of computing load for SBMV on GPU devices, GPU load. As described in the previous section, SBMV is the most time-consuming part such that it takes about 56% of the wall time when CPUs perform all the multiplications, GPU load is zero, at the K40 testbed. However, as the GPU load increases, SBMV takes less time and shows the best speed when the GPU load is (70%). This optimal pool load depends on the hardware performance of GPU devices such that, at the P100 testbed, with same host CPUs, it is (90%). The speedup becomes 1.44 times and 1.7 times for the target simulation at the K40 and P100 testbeds, respectively, against the case when GPU load is zero, only CPUs are used for simulations. Then let us discuss why this optimal GPU load becomes about 70 and 90% at the K40 and P100 testbeds, respectively. Since the performance of SBMV depends on various factors such as computing units, memory bandwidth and latency, network speed, and PCIe bandwidth between host and GPU device, it is not easy to clearly extract the exact value of the optimal GPU load. However, the ideal value of the GPU load could be approximately calculated using only the theoretical peak performance of computing units, because the performance of SBMV would be maximized when both CPUs and GPUs complete computing operations at the same time. If we denote the peak performance, in the unit of floating point operations per second, FLOPS, of host CPUs and PCIe connected devices by FANPV, respectively, the optimal GPU load, X, can be calculated as the following equation. 1. Since a single computing node of the K40 testbed has a FOF about 0.736 times 1012 flops for 20 CPU cores of Xeon E5-2650V3, and a PTOF about 2.620 times 1012 flops for 2 Tesla K40 devices, Xi's derive to about 78.1%, which it is a little higher than the measured value, 70%, due to the ignorance of other factors, memory bandwidth, etc. For the P100 testbed, PTOF about 10.600 times 1012 flops, size also evaluated to about 93.5%, while we find it at tilde 90%. Even though the derived values are not strictly accurate, we can still explain why the optimal GPU load of the K40 and P100 testbeds turns out to be higher than the 1, tilde 65%, measured with Xeon finite corner coprocessors.